My name is Meera Vishwanathan, and I work for the RTI International Evidence-Based Practice Center. My colleagues and I wrote a systematic review for Cochrane entitled Universal Screening for SARS CoV 2. SARS CoV 2 is the virus that causes COVID 19. COVID 19, as we all now know, has been devastating globally. Screening involves asking people about their symptoms, checking their temperatures, asking about travel history, recent exposure to those who are infected or suspected to be infected, a combination of those approaches, and rapid tests. Screening could be a really effective way to prevent the virus from spreading further if we can successfully identify those who are infected and they can be told to stay away from others. This really matters for SARS-CoV-2 because people who are infected with the virus can be asymptomatic or not show symptoms for a really long time and yet be able to infect others. But for screening to work, it really requires a series of public health actions. So those who screen positive need to have a confirmatory diagnostic test. Then if they turn positive, they need to isolate. Their contacts need to be traced. And those who've been in contact with people who are infectious need to quarantine. Without these actions, screening will not work in preventing the virus from spreading further. To answer the question of whether or not screening works, we looked for studies of effectiveness and accuracy of screening in general populations. This means we looked for studies of populations who were not known to have the virus. The screening strategies we looked for included asking people about their symptoms, checking their temperatures, asking about travel history, exposure to those who are known to be infected, exposure to those who were suspected to be infected, a combination of those approaches, or rapid tests. We expected these studies to compare their results against a confirmatory diagnostic test, like the reverse transcriptase polymerase chain reaction test, or RT-PCR. Because this was a rapid review, we skipped some steps, but we feel confident that the steps that we skipped do not undermine our review conclusions. We found evidence on 7 strategies of one-time screening, and these included screening for temperature, symptoms, travel history, exposure to those who are known to be infected, exposure to those who are suspected to be infected, a rapid PCR point-of-care test, a combination of those approaches, and then additionally, we found one study of repeated screening for symptoms, and we also found some modeling studies. Our main findings come from 17 studies of over 17,000 participants. And what they show is that screening is not very sensitive. So if you took a sample of 100 infected people, these screening strategies incorrectly identified between 20 and 100 as healthy. This means that at their best, 20% of those who were infected would be identified as being healthy. And at their worst, all 100 would be identified as being healthy. Similarly, these strategies were inaccurate in identifying those who were healthy. So in a sample of 100 healthy people, these strategies at their worst identified 38, or more than a third, as being infected. Unfortunately, the studies that we reviewed were quite limited in their description of methods, making it hard for us to judge how reliable they really were. Another reason for caution is that these studies all compare their results to the RT-PCR, which is itself not very accurate. So our findings are quite uncertain. Our findings mean that at the current time, for the strategies that we reviewed, they are quite inaccurate and likely to misidentify those who are infected as being healthy. They're also likely to misidentify those who are healthy and tag them as being infected, causing them to have to potentially isolate unnecessarily. We hope that health professionals and researchers will continue to develop more sensitive rapid tests. And if these can be produced more cheaply and made more widely available, and are more accurate, they can be another tool in the arsenal against this virus. These actions would have to be coupled with testing, isolating, tracing, and quarantining, and wearing face coverings and physical distancing for all.